Welcome to this mini project where we're going to create a video on demand backend, which is going to take any video uploaded to a source S3 bucket and convert it into any format that we require using Media Convert and then store the output in a destination S3 bucket. And this is going to be an event-driven pipeline using various as-a-service products from AWS. Now, to get started, you'll need to be logged into an AWS account with admin permissions. If you're using any of my courses, you can use the I am admin user in the general AWS account, so the management account of the organization. If you're not using my courses, then just make sure that you're logged in with an admin identity. You should also go ahead and make sure that you're in the Northern Virginia region. Now, at this point, we're going to open a few tabs to various AWS services which we're going to be using within this mini project. First, go ahead and click in the search box at the top and type S3 and then open that in a new tab. Then do the same for Media Convert and open that in a new tab. Then do the same for Lambda and open that in a new tab. And then open IAM in a new tab. Now, the first thing we need to do is to move to the S3 console and create the source and destination buckets. So go ahead and move to the S3 console and then click on Create Bucket. We're going to name the source bucket cattube-source and then prefix this with any piece of random text. In my case, I'm using AC hyphen, so my initials and then a hyphen. This needs to be unique, and so if you do get any error messages, you'll need to change this name. Now, for the region, make sure you pick Northern Virginia, so US-East-1. Everything else can be left as default and click on Create Bucket. We're going to go ahead and do the same for the destination bucket, so click on Create Bucket again. Keep the same format, only this time cattube-destination. Make sure the same region is selected. Everything else can be left as default, and then scroll down to the bottom and click on Create Bucket. So that's the source bucket created, which will store our original media, and the destination bucket, which will store the output of the Media Convert process. Now, if you want to keep your bucket list easier to interact with, just go ahead and type cattube in this filter box, and that will show only the buckets for this project. Next, go ahead and move to the Media Convert tab, and we'll need to click on the hamburger menu on the top left, move to queues, and then create a queue for this project. So you need to click on Create Queue next to on-demand queues. We're going to call the queue cat queue, and if you want to, you can put something for the description. I won't. Instead, I'm just going to go ahead and click on create queue. Next, we need to create the Lambda function, which is going to submit the media convert job anytime media is uploaded to the source bucket. So move to the Lambda console and click on create function. We're going to author the function from scratch. We'll be calling the function cattube-converter-function. For runtime, go ahead and pick Python 3.9, and for architecture, x86-64. Now, we're going to leave everything else as default because we'll revisit this shortly to update the permissions. For now, we'll just leave the permission set to default, which is create a new role with basic Lambda permissions. At this point, go ahead and click on create function. Once the function's created, scroll down and we're going to replace this template code with the code that's stored in the instructions for this mini project. So that's this code on the mini project instructions. So go ahead and select all of this code, copy it to your clipboard, move back to the Lambda console, and then delete the code that's already there and paste your clipboard over the top. Now, there is a placeholder that we'll need to update, so destination_bucket, that's currently set to cattube-destination. So highlight the placeholder as shown on screen now, go back to the S3 console, highlight the name of your destination bucket, copy into the clipboard, go back to the Lambda console, and then paste that in. Now, this function code is essentially going to receive an event from the source bucket, pass that event, and then submit a media convert job to convert the original source video into multiple different formats. The way that it's going to do that is read the event object and then pass any records in that event object, and for each of the records, it's going to use a file called job.json. Now, this is a configuration file which informs Media Convert exactly what formats to use. Now, currently, we don't have this job.json, so we need to create it. So right-click on the folder on the code source view on the left and select New File. Call this file job.json and then just press Enter, and then open that file in the code editor on screen. Then go back to the instructions for this mini project and scroll down, and you'll see a sample job.json document. Now go ahead and copy this into your clipboard. This is one I've prepared earlier, and this one converts your original document into two different formats, a standard definition and a high definition. So copy that into your clipboard and go back to the Lambda console and paste that in. So this is a long document just specifying the container format, the codec, the bitrate, and various other configuration items. So once you've pasted that in, go ahead and click on Deploy to deploy that function. Now if you're wanting to customize exactly what Media Convert does, then you've got two methods to do that. You can either consult the reference documentation and edit the job.json manually. Now I don't recommend this unless you're very experienced. An alternative is that you can go to the Media Convert console, go to Jobs, click on Create Job, enter a placeholder into the input file URL, so maybe s3:// test/test. Don't worry, we're not going to be using this JSON anyway, this is just a placeholder. And then click Add next to Output Groups, select File Group, and then click on Select. And then for destination, enter s3:// test/test. Under outputs, this is where you could use various variables to modify the output name of the job. And again, I've included a link attached to this lesson with some example variables which can be used. Now, if you were using this in production, you would configure various job settings on this screen, and then you could click on Show Job JSON, and that would configure the JSON object which we would use with the Lambda function. In this case, we're not going to be using this, so you can just exit out of this. Now, at this point, we need to create the permissions for both the Lambda function and the Media Convert job. To do that, go ahead and move to the IAM console, then go to Roles and create a role. The first role we're going to create is going to be for an AWS service, and then in the drop-down at the bottom where it says Use Cases for Other AWS Services, just click on the drop-down, find Media Convert, and then click the checkbox next to Media Convert. Then scroll down and click Next. It's going to pre-populate all of the permissions policies which are required. In production, you would be a lot more fine-grained than this. But for this mini project, we're going to go ahead and use the permissions policies which AWS suggest. So once we've done that, go ahead and click on Next. For role details, call it Media with an uppercase M, Convert with an uppercase C, and then an underscore, Default with an uppercase D, and then an underscore, and then Role with an uppercase R. And then scroll all the way down to the bottom and create that role. Then go back to the Lambda console because we're going to need to adjust the execution role that this function uses. So click on Configuration and then Permissions, and then click on the execution role name that the Lambda function is using. And this is going to take us back to the IAM console. Then go ahead and click on Add Permissions and Attach Policies. In the filter box, type Elemental Media, and then locate Elemental Media Convert Full Access. Check the box next to this permissions policy, and then scroll down and click Attach Policies. And that's going to give the Lambda function the permissions to interact with Media Convert. Now we're going to access the outputs of this job using CloudFront. So click in the search box at the top and type CloudFront, and then open that in a new tab. We're going to create a new CloudFront distribution. For the origin domain, click in the box and select the S3 destination bucket. This needs to be the destination bucket, so just confirm that. For name, just go ahead and enter cattube-origin. Under origin access, check the box next to origin access control settings recommended. We need to restrict the S3 bucket so that it can only be accessed using CloudFront. To do that, we need to click on Create Control Setting. And we can accept all of these defaults and just click on Create. And at this point, it's going to inform us that we need to update the S3 bucket policy to use these origin access control settings. And that's okay, we're going to do that as part of the next step. Scroll down to the bottom and under Viewer Protocol Policy, make sure Redirect HTTP to HTTPS is selected. Everything else can stay as default. Go ahead and click on Create Distribution. Now that's going to need to complete before we can do the final step of this mini project. But what we can do in the meantime is click on Copy Policy, and this will copy the bucket policy that we need for the origin access control settings. So click on the Copy Policy button and then move to S3, go inside the destination bucket, go to Permissions, scroll down to Bucket Policy, and then click on Edit. And in this blank box, paste in what you've just copied into your clipboard. Once you've done that, scroll down and click on Save Changes. Now at this point, we've got one final piece of configuration. We need to add the S3 event notification configuration, so whenever any objects are uploaded to the source bucket, our Lambda function is invoked, which then creates the media convert job. So to do that, open the source bucket, go to Properties, scroll down to Event Notifications and click on Create Event Notification. Under the event name, type CatTube-notifications. Leave the prefix and suffix blank. Under event types, we want this event notification to perform the action whenever any objects are created. So check the box next to All Object Create Events. Then scroll down. The destination is going to be a Lambda function. We're going to choose from our Lambda function, so make sure Choose from your Lambda functions is selected, click in the box and select the CatTube converter function, and then click on Save Changes. Now once that's done, we're ready to upload an object to this S3 bucket, and it needs to be a movie file, specifically one with cats. So go ahead and move to this website, Pexels, and the link for this is included attached to this video. Go ahead and find whatever cat video looks entertaining to you. It can be any of these. Just scroll down until you find one that looks good, and then click on the download icon. And this will download this file to your local machine. Once you've done that, move back to the S3 console. Inside the source bucket, click on Objects. Click on Upload, and then click on Add Files, and select the movie file that you've just downloaded. Make sure it doesn't have any spaces in the file name. If it does, you'll need to rename the file and remove the spaces. Once you've found and selected the file, then click Open, scroll down, and then click on Upload. And that will begin the upload process of this movie to the source bucket. Now once this is uploaded, go ahead and click on Close, and then move quickly to the Media Convert console. Go to Jobs, and then click on Refresh. And what you should see is a job that's processing where the first input file name is the name of the movie that you uploaded. You'll need to wait for this to change from processing to complete, because this is an as-a-service product which is doing a conversion of the input file, so the object you just uploaded, and it will be doing various conversion operations based on the job.json configuration that you added earlier. Once it's complete, go ahead and move to the destination bucket and open that bucket, and you should see two movie files. They'll be named the same as the movie file that you uploaded to the source bucket, only they'll be suffixed with -sd for standard definition and -hd for high definition. Leave this screen open because we're going to need these file names. What I'll need you to do is to go to the CloudFront tab, go back to Distributions and Refresh, and make sure the status is enabled, and that means the deployment has finished. Then expand domain name and copy this domain name into your clipboard, and then paste this in to a new tab and press /, and then on the end, start by entering the name of the standard definition MP4 file, so the one that ends -sd.mp4. So paste that at the end of this line in the new tab and press enter. And what you'll see is a standard definition, slightly blurry version of the video that you uploaded. Now I want you to do the same, only this time change this URL to -hd. Now, depending on your browser, you might see this straight away, but if you're using a browser that doesn't support the specific codec that the high-definition version uses, you might see this, so a blank video. If you do, then try a different browser. In my case, I'm going to try Chrome. And if I use Chrome, the high-definition version works just fine, and I can see a high-definition version of this cat video. And that's just been a very simple example of using the Media Convert product in an event-driven as-a-service way. So we've configured S3 event notifications to invoke a Lambda function. The Lambda function constructs a Media Convert job using the job.json configuration file, which stores the configuration options for Media Convert. This Lambda function starts the Media Convert job, which loads the files off the source S3 bucket, processes them, and then writes the output to the destination S3 bucket. And we can access this either directly from the S3 bucket if we hadn't used CloudFront, or in our case, only via CloudFront, because we've configured the origin access settings on the bucket. So we can only access the bucket using CloudFront. Now, this has been a very simple example, but this is the type of event-driven workflow that many video processing applications might choose to utilize. So I hope this has been useful. At this point, all that remains is for us to tidy up all of the infrastructure that we've created during this mini project. So to do that, move back to the S3 console, and I want you to delete both of these buckets. So select the source bucket, and then click on Empty. And you'll need to confirm the emptying of that bucket. Once finished, click Exit, select the source bucket again, click Delete and confirm that deletion. And then do the same process for the destination bucket. So select it and empty it and confirm. And then select it again and delete it and confirm. Once that's done, go to the Media Convert Queues, select Cat Queue and then delete that queue. We won't be able to delete the default queue, and that's there by default anyway, so we'll leave that in place. Then go to the Lambda console, select the CatTube converter function, and delete that function and confirm that deletion. Then go to CloudFront, select the CloudFront distribution, and you'll need to disable it first, and that process will take a few minutes to fully disable and deploy that status change. You'll need to wait for that to finish. Once you see disabled and then a date next to that status, then you can go ahead and select it again and then click on delete to delete that distribution. Then go back to the IAM console, go to roles, in the roles box search for function, select the role for the Lambda function, and then click delete and confirm that deletion, and then type media, select the Media Convert default role, and then delete that role, and then confirm that deletion. And at that point, the account is back in exactly the same state as it was before this mini project, and you've completed this mini project where you've deployed a simple, event-driven media processing pipeline. I hope it's been useful. You can go ahead and complete this video, and I hope you'll join me soon for another exciting mini project.